Good morning, guys. It is Sunday morning. Today, my only like official plan is my friend Ariana. You guys have met her probably multiple times through my videos, even from America. We are going to do a video collaboration thing together, so I'm going to be filming a lot of clips for that today, and then also filming my own everyday vlog today. Boyfriend has to work, so he'll be gone most of the day, so I'll be alone. And yeah, and then tomorrow I'm gonna be doing another job, actually. So I told you boyfriend got another job, and of course I have my current one at home, but then I'm also gonna be doing this one maybe just a couple times and only on Monday because that's the day during the week that I'm off. So I do have to go out for that job, but it's like during times when the train is... Yakimo's done. During time when the train is not busy, so that's good. It's a bit far away, but yeah, I'll be doing not necessarily teaching, but more like child care and I guess speaking English with them at the same time. It's a really chill thing, not like serious, hardcore, sign a contract, work forever thing. But I think it'll be fun, and I haven't seen kids in a while. Oh! Should I wear a mask? I guess we should wear masks, right? Hmm. Should I wear the bird one? Yeah! I'll wear weird masks. The kids will love it. This is exciting. Oh my gosh, you guys. Look at that potato. This one's so good and so sweet. I cooked it really well today. I think I cooked it a little longer than usual. And it's really sweet and soft. Yes.
Let me fix my hair.
I
don't comb my hair in days. Hi.
Hi. Say hi. Hi, everybody. This is my mom. I'm talking to her. I don't think Japanese people watch my channel as much, so that's fine if you say English words.
Okay. Hi from Morgantown, West Virginia.
Yay.
Happy Mother's Day, everybody.
Anything else you want to say?
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, we're done. Okay.
Okay, me and boyfriend are going to do a quick call meeting run, and then I think he has to go to work.
Magazine comes with a whole bunch of lipsticks. Wow. Where did I get my bag? Discover Japan in your house. Oyutsujika. Smoked chicken and cream cheese. That looks good. This one's colors are pretty, but tentacles. I don't want to eat that. Caramel is my favorite. They usually don't have it in Japan, the caramel Häagen-Dazs, because in America it's like dulce de leche. But this one is a limited thing. Okay, so 7-Eleven has this like spicy fried chicken breast right now. Usually they don't have chicken breast, and that's my favorite kind of chicken, because I don't like all the fatty bits, because the texture's weird. So I'm gonna try it. I eat my hair at the same time. Oh, is it? Ooh. Oishii. Mm-hmm. Mm. Oh, it's really good. And it is a bit spicy too. Yum. Yay. All right, we're back home. I don't know if you can see, but my face is like weirdly got these red splotches on it suddenly. I don't know how that happened. It happened between the time I took off my mask to eat chicken and was eating chicken. So I don't know if it was like caused by the mask or I have like some kind of weird allergy to food. Well, then again, I haven't been eating like a lot of fried stuff in a long time, but I literally just took a couple bites and then my face was already red. It doesn't itch or hurt or anything, and it's like splotchy. My face turns red when I exercise, which is normal, but other than that, my skin's not like sensitive to anything. It might be just from wearing a mask when it's hot, because it's really hot and humid today. Yana, I don't want this to be my new normal face, because I have to wear a mask when I go outside, and it's getting hot in Tokyo. That's weird. I've never had this kind of reaction before with the splotches. Here's the rest of today's lunch. Kimchi and this broccoli and cabbage with sesame seeds. And hijiki. Super oishi. Just a heads up, this thing with the sesame seeds in it, it says on the package it has sesame seeds, but you have to like read the bottom and it says it has nuts in it, almonds. So if you have a nut allergy, be careful. I don't, luckily, but yeah. All right. I'm still working on the thing I'm doing with Ariana, but since I happen to be up in my loft bed and it's sort of kind of organized right now, I wanted to show you guys what it looks like. This is like one of the main things about this apartment I wanted is this loft. Like as soon as I came in here, I fell totally in love with this loft. It's stuck in my head at every apartment we looked at. And that's why the main reason we moved here, because I love the loft. Anyway, the lighting up here is pretty good too. I should film up here more. But anyway, let me show you guys. So we've got a nice window up here. I've done an apartment tour before, so I think I've shown this to you guys before, but I'll show you guys again. Here's my stuffed animal collection, all organized up nice and pretty. All of our like plugs and junk get plugged in over there, and then there's a little box over there that has like boyfriend's books and stuff that we need and tissues and like all that good stuff. Then here, I just hung these lights up today. Look how pretty. I like the atmosphere. And then I've got little glow-in-the-dark stars I stuck on the ceiling. I love them because when you turn out the light, then they glow and it's really pretty. And then on this end, I shoved all the blankets and stuff because it didn't look as pretty in the video I was filming. There's like a little storage area, or I wonder if I could sit back there. I probably could. A little hidey hole. I'm gonna hide there and scare boyfriend one of these days, maybe. But anyway, this is where we shove like extra sheets and blankets, and I think, I don't even know what's in that bag. I think it's boyfriend's like skiing or snowboarding or whatever stuff. And then there's a box that probably has mysteries in it. I don't know. Maybe I'll go through it. And then you can see the whole apartment from here. I love it. I love having this little area up here. It's so nice. I should pin more junk on the walls. I might do that today. Ooh, I'm wearing makeup and clothes now. So I've been working on the video with Ariana most of today. I haven't done much else besides that, actually. So yeah, but I'm gonna head out to the Combini to get some wine that is nicer looking than boxed wine, so that when I drink wine on Ariana's video, it's not cheap boxed wine and I look cooler than I am. Hey guys, I'm back from my little 7-Eleven adventure and I got some snacks I wanna try that I've never tried before, some new ones. Well, first of all, this one, I've tried this one before. It's macrobiotic something with nuts and chocolate, and it's just good when I'm craving something sweet. It's kind of like that nutsy chocolate cereal I like. And I guess macrobiotic, I'm not sure what that means, but it's like good healthy stuff. So anyway, I ate that. Then garlic. It's like hard, crunchy garlic snack version. So I'm gonna try it. Ooh, it smells like garlic. What it looks like, straight up garlic, except it's like hard and crunchy. Oh wow, that is yummy. Oh man, that is yummy. It's not like overpoweringly garlicky. It's like potato chip texture, except the shape of garlic and like slightly salted on the outside. Good, amazingly good, low calorie, delicious garlic snack. Okay, I recommend that for sure. Next, this cheese. I've seen it around and I haven't tried it. This one's cheddar cheese. So I don't like camembert, I can't say it, but that kind of cheese I don't like. But yeah, I'm gonna try the cheddar one. Ooh, it smells cheesy. It looks like a little cheese chip. Oh. That's good. Very cheddary and cheesy. It's like Cheez-Its. Oh! It's like Cheez-Its. This is like Cheez-Its. all of you Americans watching this who are in Japan without Cheez-Its, this is the solution to your problems. Oh my gosh. Oh, natsukashi. Yes, I found the replacement for Cheez-Its, you guys. These right here. Next up, another cheese-related snack. This. I think it's just, yeah, cheese 100%. It is just cheese in crunchy snack form. Let's try. Well, it looks like cheese. It's got the texture of cheese. It's like basically just cooked cheese. Yeah. It's like chewy. Mmm. Mmm. Yeah, it's just like your basic, like, American cheese it tastes like. Like normal processed cheese cooked into a little ball. And it's got like the texture, kind of chewy texture. That's good. But it's not as amazing as this because this tastes like Cheez-Its. Ah, but this one's 100% cheese, which is cool, I guess. Well, like processed cheese is not like good fancy cheese. Okay, then next up, I've tried this one before. I just wanted to show you guys because it's amazing. But it's Sembei, that's like squishy and bendy and flexible. So it's like mochi, kind of, but salty. It's like soy sauce flavored and it's really yummy. It's called Yure Sembei. Yeah, Yure Sembei. Yure Sembei, janai. Nude Sembei. Yeah, that's what it is. This stuff is good too. But yeah, that's what I got. Oh, and I got wine. I tried it. It's good. It's not sweet. I thought Bordeaux meant sweet, but this one is not sweet. But I still like it. I never not like wine, though, really. Well, sometimes. But anyway, next up, I got this magazine that comes with these lipsticks because I want to try these lipsticks. Let me show you these lipsticks up close. I hope they're good, but it's like 1,200 yen. That's like $12 for this magazine. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Lipsticks, so I doubt they're gonna be great quality, but let's find out.
Okay, here they all are. I guess I'll just swatch them all and then show you guys how they look.
Okay, this is the order I swatched them in on my arm. I'll show you that in a second.
Okay, and then here they are, the swatches. They are not as awful as I thought they would be. They have kind of a chemical-y smell, but other than that, there's like no scent to them. Some of them are better than others. The blue one and that clearish one are supposed to like change colors on your lips. But yeah, that's not totally awful. I haven't tried them on my lips or anything yet, but, you know, for that many different colors and for that cheap, why not?
Okay, so I tried this like the orangey one, this one, because it was like a weird color that probably wouldn't look good on me, but I tried it on just to see, and actually that covered pretty well. And I don't think they all have that chemically smell. I think just maybe one of them, because when I smelled like the swatches, I smelled a slight chemically smell, and I don't know which one. So maybe it's a weird blue one. It's probably the weird blue one. But anyway, this color doesn't look good on me, but it covered my lips pretty well. It feels okay. It doesn't taste weird or smell weird. Not bad. Not bad at all for 10 mini lipsticks. Cool. Here's some better lighting. The more I look at this, the more I kind of like it. I don't know if you guys can see it so well, but it's a weird color that I would never actually buy, but I'm kind of glad I have it now in a way that I wouldn't have normally bought it. So, interesting. All right. I also tried on this pink sparkly one. This one smells chemically. I think it's probably the sparkly ones that have that, but it looks okay. It doesn't have a weird taste. Okay, now I also tried this brownish one, the lighter brown one, not the lightest brown one that's orange, but it smells kind of waxy, like a crayon, very slightly, and actually the color's really pretty and covers well. I'm kind of impressed. I don't know how it would be if I wore it all day, but I am actually impressed with these, kinda, some of them. Not bad. This was not a total waste of money. Actually, either way, it wouldn't be because it was fun and exciting and interesting for me. It entertained me for like a good 10 minutes, so yeah.
Okay, no, wait, you guys, sorry. I had to try one more just because I was really curious. But the darkest one, this dark brown, here it is. You can't really see in detail. It is slightly patchy and it was hard to get it on, but the color is nice. Don't know how long it would wear. It doesn't cover as clearly as some of the other solid colored ones, but it's still interesting and it doesn't smell or taste weird, so. Interesting color. Oh, it looks like this one will transfer really easily and kind of wear off pretty quickly, I think. Oh, inside the magazine it shows swatches of all the colors, too. Oh, this is kind of cool. The green car attendant for the Takasaki line, or the Utsunomiya line, or whichever one it is. It's a thing about that. It's got about, like, that fashion, and I guess, well, I don't know, because I didn't read it and I'm lazy. But, wow, that's cute. I used to ride this train a lot when I lived in Kumagaya. But I never rode the green car, so I never got to see one of these girls. Her necktie is so cute. It reminds me of Ariana's necktie. She shows how to tie for her flight attendant uniform. Actually, I'll link you guys to that because it's really cute, and I kind of want to try this. Oh my gosh, you guys. Remember how I bought a magazine before? Because of the stuff that came with it? It's the same magazine. I guess this magazine just comes with cool stuff. Neat. Okay, so I finished the masks for my boyfriend's parents. The darker one is for his dad, and the pink one is for his mom. And they both have puppies because they love puppies. Okay, so boyfriend just tried this one. He said he doesn't like it, actually. It's his least favorite out of the ones we've been trying recently. But I like it. I think it's good. It's not, like, outstandingly, like, what is my hair doing? What is that? It's not outstandingly amazing in my head, but it's not at all bad. It tastes like wine.
Wine.
It doesn't taste grapey though. I just took another sip. It has kind of a bit of a honey flavor to it. I think that might be why boyfriend doesn't like it. He's not a fan of sweets, like that kind of sweet. So maybe that's why. Okay, you guys, I'm still editing, but I'm done with vlogging for today. So I will see you guys tomorrow.